for some burgers. We're gonna have blue cheese, ground beef. Check out that ground beef. Isn't that beautiful? Not really, but it'll do. We're gonna have some garlic in there through adobo. Now, if you don't know what adobo is, you better recognize, because this stuff is absolutely out of this world. It looks really yellow, but it's not going to turn the burger yellow. It's just gonna turn the burger perfect. Now, here's how we measure this stuff. How many ounces would you say that is? Just enough. Perfect. Now wash the hands. You don't have to record this. I gotta psych myself up to touch this stuff. I still... Okay, I'm good. All right. Now this blue cheese is gonna mix right into the burger. Make sure you get all the cheese, all of it. You're gonna need it. It doesn't make the burger fall apart. In fact, it kind of makes it stick together a bit more. Make sure you got it all. I even got my dog angry. Can you believe that? Let's make these patties. I'm thinking 1/4 pound, 1/3 pound. Maybe that's enough. I don't know. Here's how I make them. You make them however you want. But I've got one hand that's still stationary. The other hand, I use these fingers to shape and also my thumb for the edge. I use the pressure in my top hand to go ahead and squeeze the burger down so it gets wider and wider. My thumb keeps it, well, from falling apart. So basically, I've got a nice little burger, just like that. If that's not good enough, get two dishes, cereal bowls, whatever they are. You can go out and buy a burger press, that's up to you. Just smash them like that, tighten them up a bit, and you've got yourself a uniform burger. If you've ever wanted to make burgers that are the same size all the way around, there you go. And we just make the rest just like that. All right, come take a look at these. Get in real close. Now, you see the ring that the bowl made, that's great, but the reason some people's burgers they ball up, or the center, you know, it starts to just, instead of turning into this, it turns into that. The reason why is because as 20% of this is fat, that fat's gonna drip out of there, or it's gonna just fall through the grates, and that's 20% of that thing, so it's gonna tighten up, and the only place it has to go is in. So if you make an imprint just like this, then what you're gonna find is that as it tightens up, the beef is gonna fill in that hole in the burger, and you're gonna have a level burger every single time. Don't you ever forget it. That's the way to roll.
Homemade. This is...
Look at this, no label. This is like secret stuff, you know what I'm saying? You are privileged.
Then here's the burgers. Got an 80-20 ground chuck. And you see 30 patties in there, but I'm only gonna make 15 burgers because I'm gonna stuff them with pepper jack cheese. So, hope you're hungry, buddy.
You kidding me? I told the neighbors if they smell it, come on over.
Absolutely.
Wow, pepper jack cheese.
You can't go wrong with pepper.
No, you cannot.
Pepper jack and barbecue. Done.
Well, come on, show us. Show us how it's done.
All right. You really don't need a whole lot of this on there. Just a little bit to give it a little nice, give the meat a little flavor. A little salt, a little pepper. A little light on the garlic.
Now that's garlic powder or garlic salt?
Garlic powder.
Powder.
Already got the salt in there. And I take one whole slice of pepper jack that I've quartered, slap it right in the middle, and cover up. And like I said, you want to try to get this as flat as you can. These are now half-pound burgers each.
Wow.
They were each a quarter-pound patty that I'm going to put together with pepper jack, and now you got you a nice half-pound burger. Man-sized burger.
So what's like your secret or your technique to make sure the edges don't come apart?
You're just going to have to work them together as best you can, because you don't want that cheese oozing out while it's on the grill, because you're not going to get it back in once it's out. That's for sure. But just work it around real well. You don't have to make a perfect patty. But like I said, try to keep it as flat as you can. And then I come along on top and give it a little
more love.
A little more loving.
There you go.
With salt, pepper, and garlic. Put that on both sides of the burgers and then stuff them with the cheese and put them together.
I feel like I'm getting a private lesson.
You're getting a school. This is my secret barbecue weapon. This is some of my Hogs Gone Wild barbecue. In some of my newly made barbecue sauce that I've made.
No way.
Sauteed with onions, and it's going to go on top of the barbecue burger.
Oh, that's like cheating.
It's what our Hogs Gone Wild 3B barbecue burger. Biggie's barbecue burger.
There's meat in there. What meat is that?
Pork. That's my pulled pork.
That's going to be... Don't you worry about that. What I got coming on this grill, don't worry. Okay. I'm bringing it too.
That's fine. This ain't no restaurant where you go and get a barbecue burger and you just get a patty with barbecue sauce on it. This is a real barbecue burger.
This is crazy.
The sauce that originally came in that jug was from a chain restaurant. I just dumped it down the drain and put some good stuff in it.
So are you going to tell us any secrets or what? Come on. You can't tell us? Tell us a couple things that are in the sauce.
There may be a little bit of tomato in it.
Oh, geez. Get out of here. Sweet with some heat.
A little bit of little tomato sauce, some molasses, honey, a little spice here and there.